SV Math Teach back again, this time graphing from standard form. On the previous video, we graphed from vertex form. This time we're going to graph a parabola in standard form, which is ax squared plus bx plus c. Now, if you were going to pull information from your equation, a couple things you want to know. First off, the axis of symmetry, which is the line that goes right down the middle of your parabola, right? If this is your parabola and here's your vertex, then the axis of symmetry goes right down the middle. It's the way to identify the left and right sides of your parabola. We can pull that by using this formula, which is going to be super valuable. It's just the opposite of b, and the b is this one, opposite of b over 2 times a, which is this one. So we just use those coefficients, and we can identify what the axis of symmetry is. You'll notice the axis of symmetry also has its x value in the vertex, and then simply put that x value into your function, and you get your y value. So you can identify your vertex pretty quickly. Super valuable on projectile motion questions, things where a cannonball is shot into the air, and so on. Your y-intercept is, well, it's just that c value, right? The c could be positive or negative, so the y-intercept is 0, c. Let's look at one of these in action, and then we'll graph it, and that'll be it. This one says identify the axis of symmetry. So the very first thing I'm going to do is identify my axis of symmetry. So the x value is going to be negative b over 2a. So in this case, my b is 2, so negative 2 over 2 times a. And a is a half, so I have negative 2 over 1, which is negative 2. And that is the beginning of my vertex. So I'd probably write something like the axis of symmetry is x is negative 2 to keep everybody happy. For the vertex, I have negative 2, and now I need to plug the negative 2 into the function. So my function's 1 half x squared, so 1 half negative 2 squared, plus 2x, so 2 negative 2s, minus 8. And that's going to give me 1 half of 4 minus 4 minus 8. That's going to give me 2 minus 4 minus 8. Negative 2 minus 8 is negative 10, so that goes here, and now my vertex is done. So negative 2, negative 10. My y-intercept is right here, so my y-intercept is 0, -8. And is it a minimum or a maximum? We're going to actually use the a value one more time. In the last video, we used the a value to determine compression and whether it's flipped over or not. This a value is positive, which means it's going to look like, well, your kind of standard parabola. It's going to look something like this. That means the vertex is going to be at a minimum. So we're going to choose minimum. If we want to identify the minimum, we just use the vertex because that is the minimum. And then the domain and range. The domain is the left and right movement. As you can see, a parabola is going to have no limit on the negative or on the positive side for your domain. So that's how I would list my domain. For the range is the up and down. Now the range does have a hard limit at the bottom. This range limit at the bottom is going to be, well, it's your y value in the vertex. It's negative 10. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start at negative 10, but instead of a parenthesis, which indicates kind of a almost like a soft barrier, I'm going to have negative 10 with this bracket here. This bracket's going to indicate that that is kind of like an or equal to. That is a hard kind of stop, but it goes up to infinity, right? It goes up to infinity. And since we never make it to infinity, I'll use the open-ended sign there, that'll be for your range. So that takes care of everything it's asking. Now, as for the graph, let's just transfer it down. And here we go. My vertex was negative 2, negative 10. So negative 2, negative 10 looks like this. I didn't really come up with a lot of points, but what I will do is I'll say that my y-intercept is negative 8. So here's where that negative 8 kicks in. See how it's negative 8? And this would have been my axis of symmetry. Well, I'm going to zoom in. See how it's two spaces? Well, if it's symmetric, it's two spaces the other way, and that right there is another point. So now I have myself a couple points, and at this point, I could do a few things. I might make myself a table of values. It kind of depends how detailed your teacher wants you to be. What I don't know is what happens when x is negative 1, right? Because I don't really know what's happening in here, so I could probably put in a negative 1. And if I put in negative 1 for the record, then negative 3, which is symmetric to it, would be kind of a free point. So we like that. It's kind of a 2 for the price of 1. I might also be interested in what happens over here when x equals 1 or x equals 2, and I could figure out how tall this graph is going to be. So if I put maybe a 1 in here, which is probably what I would do, then I could imagine getting some symmetry over on the negative, what would that be? 1, 2, 3 to the right, so 1, 2, 3 to the left, so negative 5. Once again, 2 for the price of 1. For my purposes of this video, we're going to keep this nice and quick, clean everything up a little bit, and I'm going to graph. So while you could use a table of values and get a more detailed graph of the function, you definitely have the idea right here. And that is how you graph using standard notation.